Both COVID-19 and influenza can cause pneumonia and ARDS, which is acute respiratory distress syndrome. Both of these can cause respiratory failure and death. We know that COVID is more likely to cause severe disease compared to influenza and has a higher case fatality rate. We also know that COVID is much more likely to cause blood clots compared to influenza. In this recent study published in the New England Journal of Medicine, they actually compared lung autopsy findings from deceased patients of COVID and influenza, and they compared these to the findings of people who died of other causes who had normal lungs. This group with the normal lungs served as the control group. So pneumonia is a very broad medical term that refers to inflammation within parts of the lung or parts of both lungs. This entails the tiny air sacs of the lungs called alveoli to fill up with inflammatory fluid, which impairs the flow of oxygen from the air to the bloodstream. The consequences of pneumonia, whether caused by COVID-19 or influenza, can result in dangerously low oxygen levels in the bloodstream, and if not treated, can result in death. Sometimes if pneumonia is severe enough, it can cause ARDS, which refers to severe inflammation within both lungs, which causes extreme difficulty with getting oxygen into the blood. This is a well-known syndrome that can occur with either COVID or influenza pneumonia. So SARS coronavirus 2 inflicts a particular type of damage in human lungs that is somewhat different from the picture that we see with influenza. To understand the differences, researchers in this study looked at the lungs of 7 patients who died of respiratory failure from COVID-19 and then compared those to the lungs of 7 patients who died of pneumonia that was caused by influenza A. They also compared them to the lungs of 10 uninfected lungs, which came from people whose organs had been donated for transplant but were not used. So these were normal lungs. This was the control group. The researchers were careful to match as well as they could the gender and the age of the patients, so their comparisons among the groups of patients would be meaningful. All of the lungs came from patients who were older and whose average age in the COVID-19 group ranged from 68 years old for females and 80 for males. Average age in the influenza group was 62 for females and 55 for males. For the normal lung group, the average age of females was 68, and for the males it was 79. So the three groups were fairly evenly matched in terms of age, and each group was composed of both men and women. There was an interesting difference in the actual weight of the lungs in the three different groups, with the average weight of the lungs for patients with influenza pneumonia being significantly higher than those of the lungs from those with COVID-19 pneumonia. The reason behind this difference in lung weight is probably due to the different pattern of infection in influenza pneumonia, which I'll get to in a little bit. The normal lungs had an average weight that was lower than those of either of the COVID group or the influenza group. And on further microscopic exam, the lungs of the patients with COVID and the lungs of the patients with influenza showed a common pattern. They both had widespread damage to the alveoli. The researchers also saw that in both COVID and influenza groups, they had the presence of lymphocytes, which is a type of white blood cell, and these lymphocytes congregated around the small blood vessels that supply the alveoli, the lung capillaries. White blood cells are one of the body's main types of immune cells and are mobilized in the presence of an infection. In addition, the lungs infected with influenza virus had massive fluid accumulation, meaning edema, around the lungs, as well as deposits of fibrin, which is a protein involved in blood clotting. Together, this edema and deposits of fibrin account for the increased weight of lung tissue in the influenza patient samples I mentioned earlier in this video. And that's not to say that the COVID group didn't have these findings, it just wasn't as much compared to influenza. But perhaps the most interesting and important finding of this research revealed damage to the lung capillaries. The lining of these capillaries is called the endothelium, and the cells that make up the endothelium have ACE2 receptors on them. The cells were in fact infected with SARS coronavirus 2. The researchers in this study found severe microscopic injuries to the endothelium here, with actual disruptions of the cell membranes. They also found widespread clotting in these lung capillaries surrounding the alveoli, which included actual blockage of the capillaries, and microangiopathy, which involves thickening and weakening of the small blood vessel walls, which begin to leak blood and protein, further slowing the flow of blood through these capillaries. Although fibrin clots in these lung capillaries were in both the COVID group and the influenza group, they were 9 times as prevalent in the COVID group compared to influenza. What's more is that in the COVID group, they actually had new blood vessel growth primarily through a process known as intussusceptive angiogenesis. Say what? Let's break that down to what that means. The word angiogenesis means the formation of new blood vessels. The term intussusceptive refers to something telescoping inside of itself. In this context, it's referring to new blood vessels being formed by a pillar of tissue within another blood vessel, effectively splitting that vessel in two. So if you imagine a blood vessel is running this way, so from me to you, and you're looking down the pipe of that blood vessel, what's going on is that from that inside, there's actually a new blood vessel forming and going to different parts of the vessel. So it's like going from here to here, or it could be going from here, maybe down to here, something like that. So if you look at it from a 3D perspective, it's actually forming new blood vessel inside other blood vessels. The researchers believe that this process contributes to more problems with clotting and inflammation of the lining of the blood vessels compared to that of influenza. So angiogenesis was much more prevalent in the COVID group compared to the influenza group, and there wasn't any angiogenesis at all in the control group. The researchers also looked at the ACE2 receptor, which is what allows the SARS coronavirus 2 virus to gain entry into the cells. Compared to the lungs of the control group, there were more ACE2 positive cells in the lungs of both COVID and influenza patients. The COVID-19 group had the highest number of ACE2 positive cells in the endothelial cells, followed by the influenza group. The control group had the least amount of ACE2 positive cells. Now, the researchers in this study speculate that the reason for more angiogenesis in the COVID group is because of the evidence of viral invasion of the endothelial cells, because of that ACE2 receptor being more prevalent there. Also, endothelial cells in the COVID group showed cellular swelling and disruption of the junctions in between cells. Now, as with all scientific research, there are limitations to an individual study. For example, in this case, the sample size of just 7 patients in each group is a limitation. Also, the influenza patients in this group were further along in their disease course compared to the COVID group, so that may or may not have an impact on these results. Clearly, more research is needed, but this study demonstrates some similarities as well as clear differences in the pathological findings in lungs of patients who've died of COVID pneumonia versus influenza pneumonia. The evidence so far is showing us that COVID not only has the potential to cause widespread inflammation within the lungs, but also it drastically affects the blood vessels within our lungs, and that includes the high potential for developing blood clots. This is consistent with a lot of the other studies that we've seen already, and something that I've talked a lot about already in my other videos. So to see more of my videos, click on that subscribe button, click on that bell notification as well so you get notified of when my next one comes out, and I'll see you then.